Hey, James Murphy here with mCoding. In this episode, we're talking about positional-only and keyword-only arguments in Python. This is a normal function definition with three arguments, A, B, and C. As is, we can pass any of the arguments as either positional or keyword arguments. Here, we pass them all as positional arguments. And here, we give all keyword arguments. The order of the arguments doesn't matter when we use keyword arguments. And we can mix and match, passing some parameters as positional and some as keyword arguments. You do have to pass all of your positional arguments first, though, so this is an error. This gives callers of the function f a lot of flexibility in how they want to call it. But sometimes we don't want to give them all that flexibility. And for those cases, we can actually require that certain arguments are passed as positional arguments, or require that they're passed as keyword arguments. Let's see how syntactically you would make an argument either positional or keyword only, and then, more importantly, let's see why you would ever want to do this. Let's start with keyword only arguments. Inside your parameters, put a star. The arguments before the star can still be passed either as positional or keyword arguments. Things after the star now have to be passed as keyword arguments. Or they could be omitted if they have a default value. I guess, obviously, if you try to pass a keyword argument as a positional argument, you get a syntax error. We're going to have stars and slashes and star stars, and it might be a bit tricky to remember. Here's the way that you should remember that everything after the star is a keyword argument. Recall what star args does. Star args eats all remaining positional arguments. In this case, our positional arguments are 1 and 2, which line up with A and B. There aren't any more positional arguments, so args just becomes the empty tuple. If we pass additional positional arguments, that's where they show up. Okay, great. Args swallows up anything that's positional. So logically, anything that comes after star args can't be positional. Otherwise, it would have just been part of args. So this is actually another way to force an argument to be a keyword-only argument. Anything that comes after star args or star whatever variable name must be a keyword-only argument. That's how I remember that everything after a star is keyword-only. I'm just imagining it's short for star args, but I don't care about the args variable. But the plain star actually has a benefit over using star args. Unlike star args, the plain star does not swallow up all the rest of the positional arguments. So this call, where I have four positional arguments, is an error. Whereas if I used star args, that 3 and 4 would just get swallowed up. This can be a problem because it gives the accidental opportunity to pass in something that you didn't mean to. You could check to see if there were any extraneous positional arguments that were passed in and then raise an error if there are, but that's just a lot of extra unnecessary work. Instead, just use a star and don't give it a name. Okay, but why would you want a keyword-only argument? Keyword-only arguments are most often used as options or settings that slightly vary or modify the behavior of some code. This combined function just takes two iterables and then puts them one after another into a big list. Maybe we want to add some kind of validation to this function. If you passed in a callable validator, then we check that all the elements are valid. We could just leave validator as a normal argument. But then it's possible someone sees a correct usage of this, combine, sub, and scribe, and maybe they don't quite look at the documentation, and they think that they can just combine any number of things. In this case, we will get an error, but it's not the one that I would hope we get. This string is taken as the validator. Then we'll get a crash when we try to use this string as a callable object, which it's not. If the thing that I tried to pass here happened to have a similar enough interface to a validator, we might have gotten the worst case. No errors at all. A silent wrong answer. Instead, we use a star and make validator a keyword-only argument. Now this caller will get the correct error that they passed too many positional arguments. You can also use this to force your caller to spell out exactly what argument they're passing in. This can be useful if you really, really want to make sure that two arguments aren't mixed up. You wouldn't want to mix up buying 10,000 of something at a price of 4,500 and buying 4,500 of something at a price of 10,000. Using keyword arguments can minimize the risk of this very plausible human error. What about positional-only arguments? Here's the syntax. In your argument list, put a slash. There's no equivalent of star args for slash. This is the only way you use it. Any parameters before the slash must be passed as positional. So it ends up looking like this: positional arguments first, then the slash, then normal arguments. They can be passed either as positional or keyword arguments, then a star, then keyword-only arguments. You can even throw in star-star quargs to catch all remaining keyword arguments. I know this notation is kind of annoying to remember. I always start with the star. Star is like star args that eats all positional arguments. Anything to the right is keyword arguments, and the things to the very left must be positional. Of course, you can mix and match all of these. A slash directly followed by a star is a common pattern to force all of the arguments to either be positional only or keyword only. A slash at the end means everything is positional. A star at the beginning means everything is keyword only. But the only way to really get the hang of it is to just try a few. Okay, now what are the actual use cases for positional only arguments? Consider this function checkTruthy. It checks that the argument x is truthy and otherwise raises an error. The context of this function is incredibly general. It wouldn't be specific to any particular domain or part of a program. So why is its argument name x? Well, it's named x because variables need names and I just picked x. But x is not a meaningful name for this argument, and I claim that there really is no meaningful name. I mean, you could call it object or something like that, but is that really that meaningful? When you use this function, just pass in whatever you want to check as truthy. This argument is best portrayed just as the argument to the function. It doesn't need and it shouldn't have a name like x. So in this case, we use the slash at the end of the argument list to force it to be a positional-only argument. If I do this, then at some later time, I'd be free to change the name x to something else. For instance, later I might want to decide that I want to check any number of arguments for truthiness. I can change x into star vals and then loop over the x's. Because none of the people calling this function referred to the variable x, this is now a completely backwards compatible change. Another use case that I find often comes up with positional arguments is when the placement of the variables mimics some kind of mathematical expression. In this case, I'm looking at raising x to the yth power and taking it mod some number. In this case, the names x and y don't really convey which one is being raised to the other power. It's more the fact that x comes first and y comes second that x is being raised to the y. And in this case, I think actually specifying the modulus this way makes it even more clear. So to me, it makes sense to additionally make mod a keyword-only argument. What about all three? Is there any case where you really want positional-only, positional or keyword, and keyword-only? In fact, there are zero examples of this in the entire Python standard library, with the exception of the tests that this feature works. There are a few cases, though, where you do this, where all of the arguments are positional only or keyword only. The best example I could find of this is actually the data class decorator. Data classes have tons of different features that you can turn on and off, so those make sense as keyword only arguments. But data class is a decorator. So by definition, it takes a single callable as an argument. So I guess, yeah, that makes sense. Whatever it applies to is the unique positional argument. And finally, let's do a speed test. Are positional arguments faster than keyword arguments? And what if they're positional only or keyword only arguments? How do the timings of all of those compare? Don't bother reading all the code exactly. Here's the setup. I have a normal function with three regular parameters, and I call it with positional, keyword arguments, out of order keyword arguments, and a mixture. Then I redefine the function, making everything positional only. Again, time that, then redefine again and make everything keyword only, and then time that in order and out of order. Then I just print out all the times. And here are the timing results. All the numbers are in nanoseconds, so these are all really fast. It's pretty clear there's a slight but statistically significant difference. We have 77 and 78. And any of the variations that used any keyword arguments used at least 95 nanoseconds. So yes, positional arguments are faster than keyword arguments. It didn't seem to make any difference if they were positional only versus if you just happened to pass them as positional. Thank you all for listening. That's all I've got. Thank you to my patrons and donors for supporting me. If you enjoy my content, please consider becoming a patron on Patreon. As always, don't forget to subscribe and slap that like button an odd number of times. See you next time.